the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the feast of the Holy Family. Let us reflect the virtues found in the Holy Family, and let us be determined that these virtues be found also, be lived in the members of the family, in our own family. And so, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God,
let us pray. O God, who were pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and in the bonds of charity, and so in the joy of your house delight one day in eternal rewards. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for 30 days.
A reading from the book of Sirah. God sets a father in order over his children. A mother's authority he confirms over her sons. Whoever honors his father atones for sins and preserves himself from them. When he prays, he is heard. His doors up reaches to reverse his mother. Whoever honors his father is gladdened by children, and when he prays, he is heard. Whoever reveres his father will live a long life. He who obeys his father brings comfort to his mother. My son, take care of the father when he is old. Grieve him not as long as he lives, even if his mind fail. Be considerate of him. Revile him not all the days of his life. Kindness to a father will not be forgotten, firmly planted against the depth of your sins. A house raised in justice to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in His ways. Blessed is everyone who fears the
the letter of Saint Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another, and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all this, put on love, that is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, and peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, the Father, through Him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the days were completed for their purification, according to the law of Moses, they took him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, just as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every male that opens the womb shall be consecrated to the Lord, and to offer sacrifice a pair of turtle doves and two young pigeons, in accordance with the dictate of the law of the Lord. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, awaiting the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Christ of the Lord. He came the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to perform the customs of the law, in regard to him, he took him in his arms and blessed God, saying, "Now, Master, you may let your servant go in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared in the sight of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and a glory for your people, Israel." The child's father and mother were amazed at what was said about him. And Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be contradicted, and to yourself a sword will pierce, so that thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." That was also a prophetess, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was advanced in years, having lived 77 years with her husband after her marriage and as a widow until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day with fasting and prayer. And coming forward at that very time, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were awaiting the redemption of Israel. When they had fulfilled all the prescriptions of the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their hometown of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please remain standing. Please be seated for the homily. Brothers and sisters, Merry Christmas and Happy Holy Family Day. Let us clap our hands for the Lord. We celebrate today the Feast of the Holy Family, the family of Joseph, Mary, with the baby Jesus. Today, I am reminded of a story of a mother who sent a message to her son. The message goes this way: Mother, your dear aunt just passed away. Lol. The son responded the text, "Why is that funny?" The son asked his mother. The mother responded the text, "It's not funny, my son. What do you mean?" The son texted back, "Mama, lol means laughing out loud." The mother responded the text, "Oh my goodness, I sent that to many of my friends and loved ones. I thought lol means lots of love." Today, as we celebrate the Feast of the Holy Family, we are reminded that every family must have lots of love for one another, just as Joseph, Mary, and Jesus have lots of love to each other. We have to accept that there is no perfect family. A brother or a sister may commit a great mistake which may cause shame or pain for all members of the family. But just the same, the feast today reminds us to accept and love that offender, because still, that person is a member of the family. To have peace in the family, acceptance plays a great role within the circle of the family. Dawaton pero sultihan sa iyang nabuhat nga sala. Sinner or saint, everyone must belong to a family. In today's gospel, we read the story of Joseph and Mary, who presented their son Jesus in the temple. There, a man named Simeon saw them, recognized the baby Jesus, and uttered his prophecy about the child who would be the cause of downfall and rise of many in Israel. A prophetess too, named Anna, was there, and she spoke of a promised child that would bring redemption to Israel. Each of us is a blessing to our family. The well-being of the family is a shared responsibility. Every member of the family has a role to play, has a responsibility to perform, has a task to accomplish, has to contribute something to facilitate the growth of the family. Dili man ta makapili kung kinsay atong mapamilya. Dili man ta makapili kung kinsay atong mahimong papa o mama. Sama nga ang papa o mama, dili pod kapili kung kinsay ilang mga anak. But just an advice to the parents: Do not play favoritism, because when you play favoritism, then that would be the beginning of conflict, tension in the family. Kung doon na kay palitan og usa, imo gyud nang angayon sa tanan. Dili kay imong taguan ang usa, unya imong hatagan, because that will be known whether you like it or not. Kita mga tao ramang yuta, mga kining
Mga tawar magyuta, inahan, amahan, mga tawar magyuta. Nya, doon na yun tayo gitawag o paborito. Whether we like it or not, doon na yun kay ganahan nga anak. But just the same, imo yun ang kontrolon and you must not play favoritism among your children. Kay lisod yun kaayo kung masilo, mahiubos ang mga anak. Atong hinumduman nga ang mga anak po, you have something to contribute for the family. Because everyone, we have different gifts and we must not be spectator in the family. Nabinagyod ang mga anak, dili magtinapulan, dili magsigig katulog, ayaw pag-practice o patay-patay. Kaya inigabot ni Mugtiguang, mamatay mangyunta. Muna nga, dunay hugasan, dunay trabahoon sa pamilya, trabaho, dili kay mutago, kining anak nga tapulan, wag yun ay kaugmaon, kining anak nga murag, muanha lang nato, alas 7, alas 12, alas 7, kadabang timpong tingkaon, wag yun kay kaugmaon, muna nga, dili yun magtinapulan, dili magsigig katulog ang bata, ang kining anak, kining dagko-dagko na, dili magsigiog, kining adto sa iyang mga barkada. You have to help in the family. Dili yun magtinapulan. But I believe the foundations of the growth of the family, for the family to improve economically and spiritually, the foundations are respect your parents and honor your parents. The first reading reminds us that when we respect and honor our parents, the Lord will bless us. Muna nga kanang mutahod yun ta sa atong mga ginikanan. Bisan kung nahiubos ta, bisan kung murag nasakitan ta, tingali ang bahin nimo gamay ra, bahin ba sa yuta, nga gusto ta ka sa kining atubangan yun, pero gipaluyo ka. Nga muna nga nahiubos ka. Pero just the same, you have to honor and respect your parents. The children who do not respect and honor their parents would lead to the destruction of the family. Those who respect and honor their parents would receive blessings from the Lord. Never disobey and disrespect your parents. The Holy Family was formed and endured with lots of love. We have an example of how a family must be reared, how a family must behave. That is why today the church has gifted us with the feast of the Holy Family. We cannot hope for something less for ourselves. It is only with lots of love that we can heal and transform our own family. Take care of your own family. You can never choose a family. Kung nganong dunay kagubot sa komunidad, kana tungod kay naay kagubot sa pamilya. Paningkamuti nga makapuyo sa gugma, paningkamuti nga makapuyo sa pagsabot, paningkamuti nga imo gyud nga hatagan og respeto o gugma ang imong mga ginikanan. Aron anaa ang tingusbawan, ma-improve economically and spiritually your own family. Natong tanan, hinautunta nga atong puy-an ang pagka-respetoso o paghatag o pagtahod ngadto sa atong mga ginikanan o ingon man usab ang mga ginikanan muhatag usab sa respeto ngadto silang mga anak. One time when I mentioned this, that parents too must respect their children, one father came to me and told me, ang una gyud kinahanglan ang mga anak na gyud murespeto sa ilang mga ginikanan. But I just smiled and I hope that father has already reflected that there can be peace, harmony, and also love in the family when even the parents would respect their children. Ang tanan, importante kaayo nga naa ang respeto diha sa pamilya. E kung wala gali respeto, there will be no peace. Muna nga, pray that every family must possess that lots of love where they respect and honor their parents, and parents too would respect their children. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. Please kneel down. Please stand. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray to the Father that the Holy Family, the perfect model of every human family, may help each family grow in understanding its mission in the church and in society. For every petition, let our response be, listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
Listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
May the church, like the family of Nazareth, be an example of unity, faithfulness, and love, especially in places where families suffer internal crisis. We pray.
Listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
May government and civil leaders be mindful of the sacredness and inviolability of the family and its role in God's plan. We pray.
Listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
May husbands and wives remain faithful to their covenant of love in marriage and find their fulfillment through the sincere gift of self. We pray.
Listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
May children honor their parents and give joy to them through love and obedience. May parents bring up their children to live in truth, love, and self-giving. We pray.
Listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
May the Lord welcome to the joy of paradise the members of our families who have gone ahead of us. We pray.
Listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Listen to the prayer of your family, O Lord.
Father, hear our prayers and supplications. May we live our days in humble service to you through our concern for the good of the family. Grant our humble petitions that we may live as your faithful followers of the Holy Family.
Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated for the offertory.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my and your sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
We offer you, Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, you may establish our family firmly in your grace and in your peace. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awful mystery, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours. And begotten before all ages, he has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all what was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Martin, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be coerced to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us sing with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life.
Amen. In order to organize and facilitate the Holy Communion, everyone is requested to remain in their seats for a while. Let us wait for the priest and lay minister to be in their respective posts. There are signages on the floor to guide us where to wait, to stand, and to pass after receiving the body of Christ. Those who are seated in front will be the first ones to fall in line, and the next row, and so on. We hope that everyone would follow so that we can observe social or physical distancing. Thank you very much.
Oh,
And now let's have our second collection.
Let us pray. Bring those you refresh with this heavenly sacrament, most merciful Father, to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer of Saint Michael the Archangel. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us from battle. Be our protector against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the divine power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who roam throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Pope Francis' prayer to Our Lady, health of the sick, for our protection against COVID-19. O Mary, you shine continuously on our journey as a sign of salvation and hope. We entrust ourselves to you, the health of the sick. At the foot of the cross, you participated in Jesus' pain with steadfast faith. You, salvation of the Roman people, know what we need. We are certain that you will provide, so that as you did at Cana of Galilee, joy and feasting might return after this moment of trial.
Help us, Mother of divine love, to conform ourselves to the Father's will and to do what Jesus tells us. He who took our sufferings upon himself and bore our sorrows to bring us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection, we seek refuge under your protection. O Holy Mother of God, do not despise our pleas. We who are put to the test, and deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin Mary.
Amen.
Please be seated for a while. Let us praise God for another blessed Sunday that we are gathered to glorify His holy name. We would like to extend our heartfelt gratitude to our Mass presider, Most Reverend Archbishop Martin Sarmiento Humawad, D.D., together with Reverend Father Junli Serenas. Let's give them a big round of applause, please. Let us also thank the members of the choir, the Unified Choir, lectors, Mass collectors, and our ushers and usherettes. We are thankful as well for our Mass sponsors and altar servers and to our lay ministers. And to everyone who has been here with us in this Eucharistic celebration. Brothers and sisters, let's give ourselves a big round of applause. And as we continue to fight through to end this pandemic, always have a good heart to help, ears to listen, and a good mind to think for what is the best. Merry Christmas and advance Happy New Year to everybody. To God be the greatest glory and honor. Please all rise.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down, bow your head for the blessing. For every blessing, please answer, Amen. May your family always together, O God, over the mysteries of redemption. They have been celebrated, and grant its members the perseverance to attain the effects that flow from them.
Amen.
May the infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of His Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy day, drive far from you the darkness of vice, and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue.
Amen.
And may the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Atong daigo ng Ginoo, mahal nga Birhen Maria, Happy Family Day.